Hello students, in this lesson, let us discuss about the balance field concept. This concept is mainly required for determining the runway length, stopway length and the clearway length. So to get started with, normally your takeoff distance and the accelerate stop distance will depend upon the speed of the aircraft which has been achieved when an engine fails. Okay, so normally the speed at engine fails will be decided by the manufacturer, aircraft manufacturer. Okay, and such a speed is very critical, as the critical engine failure speed is one of the factor for deciding your runway length, stopway length and the clearway length. So if an engine actually fails prior to the selected speed, the pilot will slowly decelerating the aircraft and make use of the stopway. On the other hand, if the engine fails at a speed greater than the speed given by the manufacturer, what the pilot has to do? He has no chance of decelerating and stopping. So what he has to do is take off and maybe later take a U-turn in the turning zone and then again land for a normal takeoff. Now for piston engine aircraft, the full strength payment is provided for the entire takeoff distance as well as the accelerate stop distance. Also, the designed engine failure speed for such type of aircraft is chosen that the above two distances are equal. What are those distances? The takeoff distance and the accelerate stop distance, these both are equal. That is what we will decide in case of your piston engine aircraft. Generally, the basic runway length, what we get in the airports, is decided by the balance field concept. So based on this concept, if we go for a piston engine, we will get a shorter runway length. And if we go for a jet engine aircraft, the engine failure is not so common and the balance field concept may not necessarily result in the most economical runway design. Here what will happen? The stopway and the clearway, which are not full strength pavement, are provided on the part length of the entire takeoff distance. Now let us understand this particular figure, which will help us to decide what should be the runway length, what should be the stopway length and what should be the clearway length based on the balance field concept. Now this shows the relationship between the engine failure speed. So along y-axis you have your engine failure speed and along your x-axis you have the length required. Now let us consider V be the engine speed failure or engine failure speed, and this is corresponding to the balance field concept. Now here three cases will arise. Let us discuss each and every case in detail. The first case is case 1, in which your engine failure speed is equal to V. That is nothing but equal to the engine failure speed which we obtain by the balance field concept. Okay, so both these are equal. In actual and in balance field concept, both the speeds are equal. This is your first case. In the case 2, The engine failure speed which is V1 is less than the capital V. So as we discussed, if this is less, the pilot will decelerate and stop the vehicle. And in case 3, the engine failure speed V2 is greater than your V, wherein he cannot decelerate and stop. He has to take off and take a U-turn in the turning zone and come back to normal takeoff position. So now for these three cases, how do we decide the runway length, stopway length and clearway length? It will depend upon this figure. So runway length, see now these are the different lines what we have. This first line is the takeoff distance. So this is where your takeoff will happen of the aircraft. The second one is the runway pavement length. How much of runway is there? That length is this second line. And the third line is corresponding to the takeoff distance. Okay. And this line which you see here in the other direction, this is your accelerated stop distance line. Understood? Now you have three areas. The full strength runway, that is nothing but your runway length. The second one is your stopway length. And the third one is the clearway length. Now we have to decide for first case, what will these three be? For second case, what will these three be? And for the third case, what will these three be? Now for all the three cases, the runway length is nothing but the length up to this particular mark. The runway pavement length. Okay, so for the first case, this line you go here till this point. So corresponding to this point, check what is the length. The length is L2. Similarly, for the second case, we have to go along V1. So go along V1 up to this particular runway pavement length line and then come down to know the distance. That is nothing but L3. Similarly, for V2, go along this line up to the runway pavement length and come along in the downward direction, so you will get your L1. So this is how you will decide your runway length. Second one is the stopway length. So the next one is the stopping length. Now what is stopping length? Or the stopway length, it is nothing but your accelerated stopping distance. Minus the runway length. So this line, the accelerated stop distance line minus, you have to do the runway length or the runway pavement length. You will get your stopway length. Now for the first case, V case, you observe what it is. Here is the line of accelerated stop distance, which is L5. So this will be L5 minus the runway length, which is your L2. So similarly, for the second case, when V1 is less than V, so V1 is less than V, if you observe, this line is here, L3, accelerated stop distance, and the runway pavement length also is at L3. So what will happen here? L3 minus L3, this will become equal to 0. Coming to the last case, when V2 is greater than V, so let us check V2 greater than V. So here is the accelerated stop distance, which is L7. Minus the runway pavement length, which is the L1. Okay, so this will be what? L7 minus the L1. So these are your stopway lengths. Next, the last one is what? The clearway length. So what is clearway length? This is equal to the take off distance minus the runway length. So where is your takeoff distance? If you observe, this line is your takeoff distance line, right? So this line minus the runway length line will give you what? The clearway length in the graph. So let's check for the first case. It is what? L5 minus L2. So your stopway length and your clearway length is same for the first case when the engine failure speed is V. Now engine failure speed is V1, which is less than V. In this case, takeoff distance is L6 and the runway length is L3. So it will be what? L6 minus L3. And for the last case, when V2 is greater than V, the takeoff distance is here. That is L4 minus the L1. Now, if you see the observation, here in this case, the runway length required is more than the length which is based on the balance field concept, right? So L3, this is the major, here L2, here L1. So this is the maximum one. But if you observe, there is no stopway length, right? Stopway length is zero. But here also we have a stopway length. Here also we have a stopway length. So this design may prove to be economical as compared to your case one. Because the stopway is a paved area and it will omit the cost, and hence we can do cost cutting and this becomes economical, right? Now, when you observe the case 3, this is the minimum runway length required about all the three cases. But again, the length of stopway is more than the length of your clear way. This particular method of giving the runway length, stopway length and the clearway length, you can use if there is any obstacle near the end of your runways. Okay, so this is about the balance field concept, complete coverage. So hope you have understood it. Thank you.